feel
she gave
what I was gonna say is technical.
Matt was giving you the stink eye.
Yeah, this will all feel more natural when we do it with Grandpa.
Matt's like, what are you doing to me? I showered this morning.
Calling.
You guys are excellent students.
Yes.
We really appreciate this. So, we're going to tell you to unclip from the rope, right? Like, unclip this carabiner.
Here we go, up, up, and away.
Yeah.
Wow, above the clouds already.
This old house is haunted by ghosts made of old bed sheets. Took them from the bed where I used to sleep. No, I drive west on some back roads with the bell jar.
Made it to the top, not the top. High camp. How do you feel?
I feel good.
Yeah,
I feel good.
You came up that today.
Outstanding.
View's not bad. What'd you bring for dinner?
Food.
After Ingraham Flats, I think it's safe to say it gets significantly harder. Ingraham Flats, Disappointment Cleaver, High Break, we've identified these places as safe spots or safer spots on the mountain, and so we can't just take a break wherever we want, right? There's just hazard zones now. We're not in Disney World, okay? We gotta be cognizant of these hazards. Then we go up above the Disappointment Cleaver. And that's where things get a little more complicated right now on the route, okay? We start ascending up above the Cleaver, and we do a few switchbacks, and then we hit a section of fixed lines. And then at the top of those fixed lines, we hit a ladder. And it's just like climbing the ladder at home, except you have crampons on and a headlamp on and it's harnessed and you have ropes on and it's dark out, and, you know, but just like at home. We then switch back a little bit around some crevasses and then get to a double ladder, which is just two ladders tied together. You'll see it and be like, what? It's OSHA approved. if we're OSHA.
To my love, took it down. I climbed a mountain and I turned around.
Yep. All right.
Over there is great. And then hold, I want you to hold on to this and don't go anywhere, okay? I want you to need this rope. Keep coming.
You got it, Will. Alright, here's the update from Camp Muir. It is 6 a.m. in the morning. I just watched the sunrise from Muir Peak over here. This is my consolation prize because I did not go all the way to the top. The route from here, from High Camp to the summit right now, is the most challenging and technical it's been all summer. Crevasse crossings, ladders, all kinds of crazy stuff. And it's taking the teams 10 to 12 hours to go up and back in the middle of the night. And when we came up yesterday, can see down there the Muir snowfield all the way through the clouds and everything. I just couldn't get my heart rate under control as we got up here to High Camp. And I knew that going up something twice as steep and challenging and technical in the middle of the night, it wasn't happening. It wasn't my day to go up there. Matt was one of them. He kicked some ass. And so they had a challenging but good climb from what I hear. It's gonna take them about 5 hours to get back down here. And then we'll pack up and head to the bottom of the mountain. But, as my dad always says, discretion is the better part of valor, and I made the right choice for me today. The mountain said no to me this time around. But, I got a beautiful moonrise, a beautiful sunrise. We still have one day to go on this mountain because we got to go all the way down there today. But it's been incredible up here. It's so gorgeous. One of the most pretty campsites and sunrises I've seen. So, thanks for following along and cheering us on from afar. Jackson, Matt, and Vince.
Yo, Dave, how are we?
Badasses.
No, you.
How was that 12 hours of pure bliss? I come to find. Heading down.
When I saw the churches, the stained glass was gone.
Okay.
And the boxes were empty.
Why not?
When I saw the blind man who can't see the sun, he talked of his army and some war they won.
paradise. Yeah, it is paradise.
Nice work. Woo. Nice work. Nice work.
Oh yeah.
Dave, crush it.
Brother.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, guys. Good job. Good job.
Nice.
No.
Matt.
Fantastic.
Nice job, bud. Congrats. Okay.
I high five all of
us. Feels good.
Kiss the camera.
And we had a bunch of really interesting groups of people, some like multiple family traditions of doing a mountain, like multi-generations.
You know, expected to come in to like a cool team of people and like have a good time, but we all like kind of established some pretty cool connections and some pretty cool friendships, and that was something I didn't really expect. So thank you guys.